I welcome you all to this press briefing. So we are intent to update you on the general and the general members of the public of the security institution in Lagos State, the achievements of the command, and the steps on maintenance of law and order, and provision of adequate security for all and sundry in the state. Within the period under review, as from January this year now to mid this month, so the command has harnessed all resources within its reach and instituted proactive strategies to enforce laws and orders in all areas, which include traffic, criminal, health-related issues, especially COVID-19 protocols in the states. It is not out of point to also say that the efforts of the command have paid off and still paying off. So for the period under review, so the command arrested 234 suspected armed robbers. Last week now, there was a video that went viral where police officers were assaulted, so at Kombuta Village. Not only were they assaulted, so they equally alleged them, they called them thief, so which is just very embarrassing. And the police officer went there for official duty. They were duly assigned by the command to follow so the task force team on HP electric products. So where a petition was treating so that they are having a fake product of that HP. So the reason is best known to the people there now. So they ran at the policemen, rallied their men, and started assaulting them and accusing them, labeling them as thief. Highly embarrassing. But we thank God because of the professionalism now. That's why the fact that the policemen were armed, no single shot was fired. So they're here. So they're going to have their duty in court. We have a case of child stealing here, where a baby of 5 months old was stolen or sold for 900,000. So the mother raised an alarm, and we thank God. So we were able to rescue the baby. So we arrested the person that stole, and equally the person that received, that bought the baby. So the mother is here, the baby is here. Last week, a last man was killed, and what actually happened, the genesis was that, so these people turned out to be cultists, which they admitted. So a vehicle went through the BRT lane. It was impounded, officially, legally, taken to the last man yard there. Now, they went there now with the intention of forcibly removing that vehicle, but they couldn't. So they didn't allow them to do that. What they now did was that they just went out to look for any last man on the road. So they met these lama people on top of Atoli Bridge, doing their lawful duty. We are not even aware what happened. That their vehicle, they just got there now with their machete and descended on them. So because they are not armed, the last man officer now went different ways now. Unfortunately, one of them was overpowered, macheted all parts of his body, rushed to hospital, he died the following day. These are the perpetrators of the last man. We succeeded in arresting them, and they are going to have their date in court. A woman knocked another woman down at the cage under the bridge. So, pretentiously, she took the woman out to hospital. By the time we got to the hospital now, so she was confirmed dead. Instead of her not doing what the law says she should do, it's an accident, it's a tragic offense. He doesn't have any criminal intention. So they were now taking, so to report the case at the police station. So she connived with her friend. They went to drum the corpse of the woman. So under the bridge. So on the way to Moriga. Now knock this woman down. It was not intention. But the action she took after now goes to show that she had intention of doing that. She's here. So we got it now. So that's the woman here. So she's going to have her date in court. So the investigation has been conducted to know what actually is her motive with that action. Extrajudicial killing is going higher. We are warning members of the public. It's not the person that goes in to kill somebody alone that commits the offense. Anybody that stays by the door to make sure that to watch out for the person that committed the offense inside, either robbery or offense now, is called a libel. That is conspiracy in law. 2 weeks ago, two last week, about 1 week earlier. Instances. So where they will put, do jungle justice, roasting the human being. For whatever offense that person must have committed, it's not within us, under the law, to take law to the hand. So I'm appealing to members of the public to desist. And those who want to desist now, we have enough reasons now. So those that killed at Ajeromi, so the same thing at Badi Adea, we arrested them. We have another team here. We see them in uniform. So that's the vehicle they have there. Can I see that vehicle? That's the vehicle. So it was written there. So they have been personating. They said they are presidential policy marshal. And they deal with the task force. So who established them? They are custom people now, and they are dark container. That they are asked now to be hijacking container. They said they work with they are under the NSC office. The investigation so far revealed that they are never known to any law. Neither do they have any authority to do that. So many people go now with uniforms up and down. So imagine the atrocity they have committed with full uniform, with anchor, with everything now that they do. And they have the opportunity to even confront customs officer. Even the police are intervened that day at Apapa, but now one or two lives might have been lost. So we got them. So the container, that two containers which they attack now, we retrieve the two containers. So when they get to court, they explain their circumstances and the law that established them. Which so far, our investigation revealed that they don't have any enabling acts in this country that made them to function the way they are.